The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 3rd Canto, 25th Chapter, Text Number 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 2nd, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Nahi asab varsmana pungshang barimna sarvajogina विस्तृत श्रुतदेव भूरी त्रिपंति में असवा सो वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द इनकार्नेशन ऑफ कपिल देव देवहती पुत्र कपिल देव द प्रोपाउंडर ऑफ सांख योग So in the previous verse, he has been explained as Bhagavan Atmamaya. Bhagavan, Bhaga means opulence, and Ban means one who possesses, Bhagavatsav. In Sanskrit, when the meaning is one possesses, then these pratyas are used, both pratyaya, mat pratyaya. So, the real word is Bhagavat Sabda, and the first word is Bhagavan. So, Bhaga means opulence. So, all the opulences are there in Bhagavan. It is in the said in the Vedas, Nitya Nityanam Chetanas Chetananam Eko Jo Bahunam Vidadati Kama. What is that Bhagavan's opulences? This is Eko Jo Bahunam Vidadati Kama. Bhagavan, singular number. And Nitya Nityanam and Nityanam, plural number. So these jivas, we are plural number. Jiva bhaga savignya sa anantaya kalpate. How many jivas are there is no limit, nobody can count. Ananta. Ananta means you cannot get the limit. There are so many millions or so many thousands, no. You cannot count. So all these jivas, we, living entities, we are being maintained by that one. This is the basic information. Eko jo bahunam vidadati kam. Just like we maintain our family. One man is earning and he is maintaining his family. Wife, children, servants, dependents, workers, so many. Similarly, that one, Bhagavan, is maintaining all the living entities. You do not know how many there are. In Africa, there are millions of elephants. They are also eating 40 kg at one time. So that they are also being maintained. And the small ant, that is also being maintained. There are 8,400,000 forms of different bodies. Who is maintaining them? Maintaining Bhagavan, that Eka. Eka jo bahunam vidadhati kam, this is a fact. So why he will not maintain us? Especially those who are devotees, who have taken shelter at the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, leaving aside everything simply for His service. Just like in our Krishna consciousness movement, we have got more than 100 centers, and one center we are just reading from the statement of Navabharat Times, how they are well managed. But we have no business. We have no source of income. That is the only source of income, Krishna's shelter. Samasita ji padapallabam prabhu. Therefore, Shastra says that you take shelter of Krishna. Krishna comes also to say the same truth. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam vraja. He never says that you do this and do that, then I shall give you for your maintenance. No. Aham tva sarva pape bhavokkhasya. Not only I shall give maintenance, but I shall protect you from the resultant action of sinful life. So much assurance is there. So, Shastra also says, tasyaiva hetu prajateta kovida nalabhate jat bhramatamu parajada. Tasyaiva hetu prajateta kovida. Kovida means intelligent. Very intelligent person. So what should he try for? Tasyaiva hetu. To get shelter at the lotus feet of Krishna. Human life should only endeavor how to get in touch of the lotus feet of Krishna. That should be the only one business. Tasyaiva hetu prajateta kovida na labhate jat bhramatam uparajadha. Let them see them. Uparajadha. Upari adha. Upari means higher planetary system. There are seven planetary systems. This is in the middle. We are in the bhulo. Those who are chanting Gayatri Mantra, Om Bhur Bhuvasat, Tassavitu Varannam Bhargadhivasa Dhimai. So, there are 14 planetary systems within one universe. So, we living entities, we are wandering in different types of forms of body and in different planets. That we are, according to our karma, sometime down, sometime up. In this way we are wandering. That Shastra says, they say, you are wandering in this way. Your business is how to become materially happy, how to satisfy your senses. But don't do that. Don't do that. Then what shall I do? Tasyaiva hetu. How to understand Krishna? For that purpose you should endeavor. Then how shall I eat? No, that eating and sleeping, the business of the body, that is already arranged. That is already arranged. You don't have to work for it. Kalena sarvatra gaviraṁ tallabhati dukkha badannaka sukham. Our endeavor is to achieve happiness. That is our struggle for existence. Shastra says, tallabhate dukkhavat. Dukkhavat means, just like we don't want anything unhappy or miserable condition of life. But you get it. You don't endeavor it for it. Nobody says, let there be fire in my house, let my child die. Nobody aspires these things. Everyone thinks that my child may live, there may not be any danger, I get so much money. Nobody thinks of the opposite, but the opposite number comes. The catastrophes come. You don't pray for it, you don't go to the temple for praying, my Lord, let there be fire in my house. Nobody goes. He goes for something better. The Shastra says that which you do not pray for, still it comes. dukkhavat, without your invitation. Similarly, whatever happiness you will have to enjoy, that will also come. Tallabhate dukkhavadannath sukham. Therefore, the conclusion is that don't try for your so-called happiness or so-called distress. Try to achieve that position where you can understand Krishna and get shelter at his lotus feet. This is human endeavor. Tasyaiva hi ta prajati ta kovida na labhate jad bhamatam uparjata upari adha. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Rupa Goswami, ei rupe brahmanda bhramite kono bhagavan ji guru krishna kripaye paye bhakti lata bij. We are wandering in this way, up and down, brahmanda bhramite. Brahmanda bhramite kono bhagavan ji. If one is fortunate, he can get the information of devotional service to Krishna. He gets this information. So this assembly, this Krishna consciousness movement is an attempt to make people fortunate, from the unfortunate position to become fortunate. Everyone is unfortunate, at least in this age. Manda sumanda mandayo, sumanda matayo, manda bhagya. Now see, everyone, everywhere, there is simply problem. There is simply problem. One problem in one country, another problem in another country. There is strike, there is government, there is even the president, and he is also has to meet so many problems. At the end he has to be dragged down. Now he is going to die in the hospital. What to speak of others? The problem. Only for. Therefore everyone is unfortunate. This is the conclusion. You may think that I am very fortunate. President Nixon was thinking, I am very fortunate. I have become the President of United States. But now he is realizing, I am the most unfortunate. This is for everyone. Don't think the only the culprit is President Nixon and I am very safe. There is a Bengali proverb, Bhute pore gobor hase. Gobor means cow dung and ghute means what is called in English, the dry cow dung. The dry cow dung is used for fuel. So when the dry cow dung is being burned into the oven, the soft cow dung is laughing, oh, you are being burned, I am in safe side. He does not know that when he will be dry, he will be put into the fire. So we are laughing that President Nixon is in trouble. I am very safe. I have got so much bank balance. No, nobody is safe. They as like the same cow dung soft. When it will be dried out, it will be put into the fire. And that dryness will come to everyone. That is a fact. What is that? Death. You may be saved at the present for a few years, but you cannot avoid death, as sure as death. And what is the result of death? The same as the president is taken out from his position, everything, all honor, all money, all even life. Similarly, at the time of death, Krishna says, Mrityu sarva harascha aham. I come as death and plunder everything, whatever you have got. Your bank balance, your skyscraper building, your nice wife, your children, you have to give up. You cannot say, my dear death, kindly give me some time, let me adjust. No adjustment, immediately. Get out. So, foolish people, they do not know what is the miserable condition of this material life. Therefore, Krishna says, real knowledge is janma-mrityu jara-vyadhi, to know. That however great I may be, these four principles of miserable condition of life, they are. It is existing in the Brahma-loka, in the Patal-loka, everywhere, sarvatra, gabhira-rangasa, jalla-tallabhati dukkha-vadanna-tasukham, kalena sarvatra gabhira rangasa. In the due course of time, this is the most wonderful thing. That was questioned by Dharmaraj to Maharaj Yudhisthira, what is the most wonderful thing in this world? He said, ahani ahani gacchanti jamamandiram. Every moment so many people are dying. Sesha sthitam icchanti kim aschajam mataparam. But those who are living, he thinks that my friend has died, but I will live forever. No, the same thing. The soft cow dung will be dried up at the same condition. So, Bhagavan is not like that person. Therefore it is said, Bhagavan Atmamaya. In Bhagavan, we come here to stay for some days, say 50 years or 100 years, enjoy or suffer life. But Bhagavan does not come for that purpose. Namaṁ karmani limpanti. That is stated in the previous verse. And the second verse, it is further. Nahi jasya barmana. Nobody is greater than him. Bhagavan means, the person, nobody is greater than him, and nobody is equal to him. That is Bhagavan. Everyone is lower. The Chaitanya Charitamrita kar says, Ekala Ishar Krishna Arsabhritta. Arsabhritta. Only one master is Krishna, and others, beginning from Brahma, Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar, Indra, Chandra, all these demigods, there are hundreds and thousands, 33 million demigods. And then these Naraloka, there are so many rich men, Rockefeller, Ford, Birla, and others. They are all bhrittas, all servants. When Krishna will order, my dear Mr. Such and Such, now give up your place, go away. Finish. So therefore they are all servants. This is the position beginning from Brahma down to the end. Jastindra gopa mathavendra maho sakarma bandhanurupa phalabhajan matanati karmani niddhati kintu cha bhakti bhajan govindamadi purisam tamaham bhajan. Everyone is enjoying and suffering the sequence of his karma. Just to gopa, Indra gop, a small insect, its name is Indra gop, beginning from this Indra up to that Indra, the king of heaven. Everyone is enjoying and suffering about his karma. Jastindra gopa mathavendra maho sakarma. Sakarma, one's own activities, we are creating. We are creating our next body in this life. As you have got this life as the resultant action of my past karma, similarly, I am creating another body after death on account of my present karma. This is going on. So, we should work in such a way that we may not get another body next life. That is wanted. And how it can be done? It can be done very easily. What is that? Simply try to understand Krishna. Simply try to understand Krishna. This is the simple method. Janma karma medibham. Jo janati tattata. Takta deham punar janma neiti mameiti. Very simple. And to understand Krishna is very difficult. Yes, it is very difficult. But it is very easy also. How? Now, Krishna says, bhakta mama vijanati. If you become devotee of Krishna, then you understand Krishna very easily. Krishna does not say, by jnana, by karma, by yoga, you can understand him. No. That is not possible. Naham prakasa sarvasya yoga maya samabhrita. It is stated here that Bharishmana sarva yogina. There are many different varieties of yogi, and he is the greatest yogi. Therefore, he is known as Yogeshara, Jatta Yogeshara Hari. He is far, far above all yogic processes. The yogis, they can show you some magic. The yogi can walk over the water. There are so many, anima, logima, siddhi. But see, Krishna's yogic, mystic power, that big, big planets, they are floating in the air. Can you do that? Can you float in a small piece of stone, floating in the air? That sea, therefore it is said here, Bharishmana sarva yogina. What yogis can, these ordinary yogis can show? Of course, we are foolish person. If some yogi shows some mystic power, a little gold if he can manufacture, we accept him as God. But we forget the real yogi who has created millions of gold mines floating in the air. So, we Krishna conscious person, we are not so fooled that we shall accept this kind of yogi as Bhagavan. We want the foremost yogi, Bharishmana sarva yogi, that Krishna, Yogeshwara. We accept him as the Supreme Personality of God. Because why? Because we are trying to become devotee. And Krishna says, bhakta mama vijanati javan jaschami tattata tato mam jnata tattata. The verse. So, very simple process. The first thing is, the problem of life is how to conquer over death. We are now accepting death as compulsory. No, death is not compulsory. Just like to be put into the prison house is not compulsory. It is due to my work. Because I have become criminal, therefore I am put into the jail. It is not compulsory that everyone has to go to the jail. So similarly, we living entities, our proper place is the Vaikuntha Loka. If you accept Bhagavad Gita as it is, then after giving up this body, takta deham punar janmanai, no more birth and death, you get your spiritual body, Satchidananda Vigraha, and happily live in the family of Krishna, because he is also providing you here, and there also he will provide you with very nice preparation, as you have learned from these, Navbharat times, how our people are eating preparations from milk very nicely. So, back to home, back to Godhead, and eat, drink, and be merry in Krishna's company. That is all. Thank you very much.